repeat, yeah?
Switchblade Sermons, and that's like one of the main ones that gives me a lot of influence.
Mine would be like switching up the beats, starting with a fast beat and then changing it to like a totally slow beat. Like that to me helps with my timing and getting it right. And one thing that he says that I really stuck to in my head was the fader. Like even if you fuck up on, oops. If you fuck up on your left hand, on your record hand, as long as the timing is right on your fader, you can get away with it. Not that you should try to get away with it, but if you're really tight on timing with your fader, it'll be tight. That's what I think. Another thing would be when you talk on it, like when you talk, you know, see it as like, even if you don't rap, it's kind of like if you're rapping, you don't always want to say la 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 la. You kind of want to like, I went to the store and I got apples and cherries. You don't want to just say I got apples all the time and cherries. So that's enough. I know you can follow that. I know what you mean when I say that. You guys understand my language. And then also, you know, with the mentors, always learn. You guys are doing exactly what you should be doing, learning from the best. You know, so. Yeah.
That's
it.
Thank you guys for having us.
Thank you so much.
I had a quick question.
Yes.
For somebody who's trying to like learn double time, like that beat, that
5:130 session. What's a good like exercise to transition to that? Because it's foreign language to me. I'm like,
you can scratch to the faster beat, which is double that.
Scratch to the faster.
Like 120, so like 60 beat.
Is it the same language?
It's pretty much the same thing.
Yeah, cutting to a faster beat. Just math, that's all it is. Yeah.
It seems so foreign to me.
Yeah. So when you listen to that, it's like double that.
Right.
And just, you know, kind of out of it. But I like to scratch the faster, I mean, slower beats, faster beats, basically.
Yeah, like me, first thing of all, like if I'm trying to like go into the double time zone, I usually like to kind of warm up like between 110 and 120, so like 55 to 60, somewhere in that range, right? And just like Adia was saying, and we talk about this all the time, like it's a lot of practice, right? Can't stress that enough. That's probably like your main ingredient, right? And getting your skills up and just getting better and staying sharp. And then other than that, again, going back to also what he was saying, which is...